action, and we're just about set to kick off. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Army has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's knocked out of bounds
at about the 49.
So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
Makes the catch, and look out, out of bounds, the 47-yard line. He makes his way to about the 38.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
And that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Slings it out there incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. That brings us third and 10. Here comes the pressure. Going deep. They'll bring him down around the 9-yard line. They really got beat by the deep pass.
Against man-to-man coverage like that, it's just a foot race.
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. Play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he converts the extra point. A 6-play, 50-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Drill at the 44-yard line.
That makes it 7-2.
Here we go!
He's tackled at the 45-yard line.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run. When the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Taken down at the 43. There's a missed opportunity by the offense.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive.
Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Southern Miss is up 7. And he hits him hard at the 40. Catches it, and he's looking for more.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
The 22-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's tackled in the open field. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. Tackle made at the 11-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 11-yard line. Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes at the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. And he hits the PAT. A nice 8-play, 59-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
So the score now, 14-0. At the 30, tries to get around the corner. Brought down at the 50. The defense was able to stop this offense short on fourth down last time. Let's see what they do this opportunity.
Nothing can impact an offense more negatively than being stopped on a series of downs. And that's what happened to this offense the last time they were out. It's not just the quarterback's job to try to get this offense going. I think it starts up front with a veteran offensive line. See what kind of leadership they have to try to change this thing around.
Up the middle for a nice game. They make the stop at about the 39-yard line. And Herbie, we got a guy down after that play. From the 39-yard line, it's second down. Here's a quick throw.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
I got one.
Throws it in a hurry. He's at the 20. Brought down at about the 11.
You know, they did a great job here of not just getting past a first down marker, but picking up some major yards on the play.
He's tackled at the 9-yard line. They'll get him for a loss.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Here's the 8th play of the series. He flings it left. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The Black Knights running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up, trying to get back in the ballgame. And the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Golden Eagles are punching it into the end zone when they get the chance, and that's been the difference so far in the ballgame.
Yeah, give them all the credit. It's one thing to move the football down the field, but when you get an opportunity to come up with a touchdown, you have to capitalize on it, and they've done that.
They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
Throws complete. He's hammered. There are three quarters remaining. Golden Eagles in front by 11. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 39. Inside handoff. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Quick out to his receiver. And that sets them up for the 1st and goal.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on it. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
It's the 9th play of the drive. And he's level at the 4-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 2. He makes the PAT. So an 11-play, 76-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. Tackle at the 27. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Personal foul. Clipping. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So the penalty puts them back for a first and long. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Has some daylight. He gets hit out of bounds at the 26-yard line. Great concentration to pull it in. He's tackled at about the 41. Laterals back. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 44. Taken down at the 46.
That makes it first and 10.
He fights forward to about the 46.
No gain on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Scrambling around. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Throws a strike over the middle. Tackled at the 27-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Excellent open field tackle.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. And they hit him in the backfield.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
Zips it to the back. Tackle made at about the 3-yard line. To his tailback again, and they push him out just outside the goal line. The Black Knights had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Touchdown, Army!
Really good vision here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. He didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
splits the uprights with the extra point. Army ready to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line. He makes it to the 28-yard line. The Golden Eagles are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Intercepted.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28. He fights forward to about the 30. The running back gets two on the carry.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
To that quickly, and down he goes at the 47.
Well, that'll happen when you blitz the corner and the offense picks up the blitz. It's one less guy the quarterback has to worry about in coverage. Nice read by the quarterback to keep the drive going.
Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. Second and 10, ball on the 47. It fly. Almost intercepted.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He's going to air it long. The defender had it and then dropped it. We're halfway through and it's been a good one. 21-10, Golden Eagles.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Rhys. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Rhys and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 32. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
That'll make it 7-7.
Carries the ball for a nice game.
Game 7 on the play. Third down.
And he's stopped behind the line. taken down at the 17. The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives. Out of bounds, right around the 20. It's third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 19.
Three down. Mike six.
He's in trouble. There's a strike complete. He's down. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 4. Let's go deep. That makes it 7-6.
And they make the stop at the 43. And so the fullback gets a nice gain on the option there. They're using everyone.
Well, the thing about the option as a defense, you have to account for everybody. Here, the offense gives it to the fullback, and he picks up the first down on a huge gain.
There he goes. He gets to about the 34-yard line.
That's good for him. That brings him second and one.
Brought down around the 31-yard line.
First down.
Let's go!
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He's tackled around the 28-yard line.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run.
It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Trying to change the field position with his kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Fires out to his wideout, and he hits him hard at the 21. Taken down at the 38. And a quick throw. They'll bring him down at about the 47-yard line. He's got room to run. gains his way to the 43-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line. The grab, and he's got the first, and he is drilled at the 16. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16. Caught with room to work. The 10. Nice play to set up first and goal. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. Converts the extra point. A nice 8-play, 81-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
The score now, 28-10. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Got the corner. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 40. Golden Eagles continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Gets to about the 44-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Boy, that hurts the offense to have to go 3 and out. They're going to have to think about how to get something going the next time they come out.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. And he's taken down at the 24. So with one quarter remaining, Southern Miss leads 28-10. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That makes it 7-6.
Level at midfield.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
And he just gets rid of it. From midfield, second down. At the 40. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. was complete, and he's got room to work. He gets hit out of bounds at the 20-yard line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That brings in second and goal.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Can't bring him down, and he's in. And he adds the extra point. Southern Miss is ready to kick it away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard. Under pressure, he's taken down at the 26. Flings it out there incomplete.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 26-yard line, it's third down. Fires to his fullback, no good. Down at the 47-yard line. The Golden Eagles came out from the opening kick, and they just imposed their will in this game.
Just a complete effort. You can look at the numbers. You can see that the stats show the offense has put up the numbers. The defense has done their job. It's about as good as you could hope for.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injury. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They come out in a five-wide set. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Just under 2 minutes in the game. He's at the 20, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 18. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. He fights forwards about the 16.
Gaining 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Good outside run there. Third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. the middle for a nice gain. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, Southern Miss 35, Army 10. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.